Moses is one of the most interesting characters in the Bible. I hope to show you why. So we all know that Moses was the prophet that brought down the law to the Jewish people, and he has become the symbol for law pretty much around the world. So in talking about Moses, you think about law. But there's a lot more to Moses that you need to know about. Moses was a prophet in the Jewish system of things. He was one of the oldest names in the Bible, one of the most revered figures in the Bible, because he was supposedly so close to God, and he has given to the world the Ten Commandments. The history of Moses takes us back to ancient Egypt and to the Israelites back in the time of Egypt, in ancient Egypt. He was a very fierce man for the truth and for leading the people, and supposedly the Jewish people, the Hebrew people. He was a major leader at the time when they were in Egypt. And he became, because he went up into the mountain and got the Ten Commandments from God, he became known as the lawgiver. The point we need to remember is that Moses was a very important man to the Hebrew people and into the history of the Jewish people in Egypt. He was supposedly born in Egypt and was bred in the house of the princess, and he was around royalty continually, and yet he had a love for the Jewish God, and so he protected the Jewish people, and he became so important to the history of the Hebrew people at the time of Egypt that today he even is recognized as a very important person to remember in history about law. He was the one who led them out of Egypt, according to the story that Egyptian life had become so difficult for the Jewish people, and they wanted out of Egypt. And so Moses was the one who had the strength to stand up before Pharaoh and say, "Let my people go, and we will leave out of Egypt." And so this is, even today, still remembered, a very heroic deed for Moses to step up and take the leadership of the Hebrew people and walk out of Egypt and leave Egypt. He took them up into the north, where we today refer to it as Lebanon and Israel, etc. The most important point I wish to make is the fact that there is so much more to this ancient prophet, leader of the Hebrew people, than has been discussed publicly. And I want to talk about some of those things. Moses was called by God to come up into the mountain of Mount Sinai. And God was going to give Moses what we now refer to as the Ten Commandments, which is actually a new dispensation for Jewish law, a brand new way to understand the Jewish understanding of God. And so he goes up into the mountain and he encounters the presence of God, and God gives him Ten Commandments to bring back to the people to begin a new dispensation, a new understanding of God. And so when Moses comes down from the mountain, he sees the Jewish people still worshiping God the old way. They were worshiping a golden calf because it had to do with the particular astrological times in which they were living. And the times in which they were living then, at the time of the Ten Commandments, was Taurus to Bull. And so they were worshiping the golden calf in relation to Taurus to Bull. Well, Moses comes down and sees the Jewish people still worshiping in the old way, and becomes very frustrated. Before he even talks to him, becomes very frustrated, and then throws the law. It was referred to as the law. And so Moses throws down the law and breaks the law. So Moses was the first lawbreaker. He was carrying two stones on which the laws, the Ten Commandments, were written. And so he carries these down, and then when he sees the Jewish people still worshiping the old way, he throws those down in frustration. And so that's what we get the term today, breaking the law. The Jews were worshiping the calf because they realized that they were worshiping the sun in the age, in the astrological age of Taurus the bull. the next astrological age, of which Moses was going to lead his people into the next age, was going to be Aries the Ram. And he was teaching them that there was a new way they were going to worship God. And this time they would blow the ram's horn to signify the age of the ram, the shofar. Here we have pictures showing that God is handing Moses the Ten Commandments on these tablets. The tablets themselves are very interesting, the design and what they were all about. We find that there's a very interesting connection between the Ten Commandments of the Hebrews and the 12 negative confessions of the Egyptians. The Egyptians already had 12 laws, so to speak, and they were called the 12 negative confessions. And so when you read the negative confessions and then the Ten Commandments, they're exactly the same. The only difference is one is in Egypt, they said, here are the things we will not do. It's a negative confession. Here are the things we will not do. We will not lie, we will not steal, we will not do this or that. Well, the Ten Commandments says, the Lord says, you should not do this, you should not do that. But it's very similar. So we know basically where the Ten Commandments came from the 12 negative confessions of Egypt. Well, if you remember that religion itself is a development of human creativity, and there are so many stories in different religious books around the world, so many wonderful stories in theological ideas and concepts, which obviously were just made up by men to promote their particular religious belief. But back to the Moses giving of the law, that particular scene of Moses with the Ten Commandments, the very stalls and the very stones themselves is very important. Moses is always the lawgiver, and the Jews today still respect Moses as probably one of the most important people in their history besides Abraham.